Hi children, welcome back. I want to discuss one small numerical based on electric field again. The question is, I read the question very slowly. There is a pendulum of mass 80 milligram carrying a charge 2 into 10 power minus 8 coulomb is at rest in a horizontal uniform electric field of 2 into 10 power 4 volt per meter or newton per coulomb, both are same. Now they are asking find the tension in the string when and also angle it makes with the vertical read the question carefully. There is a pendulum, first of all. I draw the diagram because I can't write the question completely. There is a pendulum, right? Pendulum bob. Okay. What is the mass of it? 80 milligram. Due to 80 milligram mass, gravitational force acts in this direction. This is, I write milligram. Gravitational force acts on it. And here there will be a tension. So in equilibrium, tension becomes equal to mg. But in this case, there is a horizontal uniform electric field. So you have applied uniform electric field in this direction. And that too, the charge, the bob is having, pendulum bob is having a charge of 2 into 10 power minus 8 coulomb. So this is having charge. This is having mass also. Since it is having charge, that too positive charge. Positive charge always will tend to move in the direction of electric field. So it experiences force in this direction. How much force? Q into E bar. Due to which, what happens? The pendulum bob will get displaced like this. The string makes an angle theta with the vertical. Now he says that the pendulum bob is at rest. And what are the forces acting on it? I draw the diagram again so that you will understand. Now, let us see. Are the diagram focused? This is the pendulum bob. With the vertical, the pendulum bob is making an angle theta here. Okay. What is the angle made by it? Theta. Now the tension will act in this direction. What is this? QE, because electric field acts in this direction. Because of that, force acting on this bob due to the electric field acts in this direction, which is equal to F electric. Another is weight of the bob acts in this direction. W bar, T bar, F E bar. Okay? Now the question says that due to the application of these three forces are acting on the bob. So by virtue of which the bob remains at rest. It is in equilibrium. So the net force acting on the bob is zero because it is in equilibrium. Net force means vector sum of all the forces. T bar plus F E bar plus W bar is equal to zero. Right? That means the resultant of these two must be acting in this direction. It must act in this direction, which just balances the tension. The resultant of these two should act in this direction, which is R bar. R bar should exactly balance the tension. then it will remain in equilibrium. For that, what we need to do? Let us say, suppose here the angle is theta, I extend it little bit, here also the angle will be theta. If this is tension, same force should act in this direction. Leave it. We go for another method, right? If this angle is theta, this angle will be theta. So this becomes t cos theta. This becomes t sin theta. Right? This is mg because this is the weight. Since it is in equilibrium, sigma fx means along x direction the net force must be zero. Sigma fy along the y direction the net force must be zero. That means this t sin theta should be equal to fe, that is qe. T cos theta should be equal to mg. Very simple to understand. So t sin theta is equal to qe. T cos theta is equal to mg. Very simple to calculate. Now tell me, what are the quantities given to us? Qe is given, E is given, mass is given, G is known to you. So, now I do one thing, I divide these two, I cancel these two, I get tan theta. Tan theta equal to Qe by mg. You can calculate Qe by mg value because I given the numerical data here. So you can calculate theta as tan inverse QE upon MG. Calculations are left to you. The value of this is 27 degree. You are supposed to get 27 degree. So we have found the angle that it makes, that the string makes with the vertical that we have obtained here. Next is we need to find tension. So, this is t sin theta and this is t cos theta. Squaring and adding, I will get t square sin square theta plus t square cos square theta is t square. T square equal to qe whole square, q square e square, mg whole square, m square g square, which is equal to t square. T equal to square root of q square e square plus m square g square. You can get the value of tension as 8.81 into 10 power minus 4 newton. A very important question to solve. Very, very, very important question. I hope you understood this. Right.